Wait, I think I see Baldur up ahead.
No. No, I would never
stay out of sight. This.
Listen.
You had no right.
I had every right. I am your mother.
You had no right, witch. I can't taste. I can't smell. I can't even feel the temperature of this room. Feasting, drinking, women. It's all gone.
But you never
gone.
Feel pain again. Death has no power over you now. You would rather die?
Feel again?
Yes.
I would rather die.
Yes.
Take it away, Mom.
I can't.
Please. Please take it away.
It doesn't work like that. Son, trust me, in time, you will thank me. You will thank me.
Come on.
Freya is his mother. Why did you keep this from us, Head?
Would you believe it slipped my mind?
What you did
I would not.
I'm at a loss.
What
I assure you, I have no reason to keep such a thing a secret.
There's the boat. We will speak more of this soon.
After I kill you.
Who is that?
We must hurry.
Not entirely sure this is seaworthy.
She will do. Give me space to work. You have done enough.
Just bear in mind this boat can only take us part of the way. Tyr's temple is near the top of a tremendous waterfall, which, sadly, we are downstream. That means even if we get there intact, we'd still need to sail up a waterfall somehow.
The Vanir built the greatest ship that ever was, and it can fly.
Skeetblothnir? Yeah, because it was designed to fly. This was not.
Nevertheless, this is the boat we have.
Perhaps the biggest iceberg I've ever seen.
At least the fire's making heat. What now? Chopping it?
Give your father.
So now the sails are loose?
Just watch.
They're pulling the sails down? But how are they gonna catch the wind? The heat from the fires! We're actually floating! And we're stuck.
Not for long. Stay with the boat. I said stay on the boat.
Staying on the boat.
Stuck on this bridge over here.
For me there.
Brother, you do realize it's over, don't you? Even if we make it back to Midgard, you and Baldur destroyed the only gate to Jotunheim. We are out of options. And that boy up there, he's in nine kinds of pain. His head's turned so far around he...
Atreus is not your concern.
Well, he might become everyone's concern if you don't do something.
Atreus.
I can help?
Together now.
We did it. We're free. We are going to get out of here.
Face me, Father. It is time to end this.
Yes, my son. It is time.
No.
It's that voice again. Do you know who that is?
I do not know.
Iceberg! Put us!
Hold on!
Need more time!
Let me down!
I will free us!
How long before we reach the temple?
Yeah, it's freezing.
As long as we maintain this speed and those fires don't go out, we should be there in no time, lad.
Yeah. How's the fire staying lit?
Would you believe magic?
Or those blades.
was your plan? You're both cracked!
We are leaving this realm. Now!
As long as we didn't wreck our way back.
It's Odin's. I'd recognize his atrocious taste anywhere.
Look at that! It's the missing panel about here. Odin must have stolen it. But why?
He always has his reasons. Might I have a look? Well, this is most unexpected.
Why? What does it mean?
I haven't the foggiest. Isn't that unexpected?
Head.
Look, clearly that's Tyr. Traveling somehow. Perhaps magically. But what's that to do with the giants that they should devote a shrine to it? I'm afraid that is none too clear.
What are those runes in the corners?
Not runes. Symbols from different lands. They mean...
war.
Aye.
How do you...
This one I know too well.
Oh.
His eyes. They are jewels. Like yours.
No doubt signifying the gift of sight the giants granted us. Give me a closer look. Interesting. Very interesting.
What is that?
Secret plans, concealed by Tyr so none could access but him. And those few others the giants trusted. And right under Odin's nose, ho ho ho! I did promise I'd get you to Jotunheim.
What do you mean, Ed? You said we were out of options.
Don't you see, brother? Odin never gave up hope, and neither should we. He knew there was a clue in here, but we're the ones who found it. These plans are for a key to some chamber Tyr's kept hidden. I don't know where it's leading or what we'll find, but it's a path.
How do we make this key?
I suggest we ask a dwarf.
That symbol on the temple door. It's a bunch of runes together. Peace, unity, hope. Other things, too.
Tyr's own design. He made this door himself.
I think this is where Odin brought all his best clues about Jotunheim. I didn't see anything.
You did not see me with someone. An old man.
What old man? Can we go?
Yes. Very well.
right, let's get back to Midgard and see about making that key. Where's that dwarf?
Tell us Baldur is the son of Freya.
He is! It's shocking every time I hear it, and yet obviously I know it. When I think about Baldur and Freya...
Mimir?
Yes, lad.
Freya.
How's that, brother?
Ed, tell me Baldur's vulnerability.
Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Wait, what is happening?
He is bewitched, not to speak of what he knows.
I am! Oh, that's it, precisely. I wonder how long that's been so. Since she had my head at her mercy, or back when I figured out Baldur's weakness.
I'm here.
Yes, lad?
You just said you figured out Baldur's weakness.
Did I? But Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Enough. This means there is a way. If he troubles us again, we will find it. Can you make it?
Is it a weapon? Armor? Or likewise an instrument of war, of which I'm a master at shaping? No? Then forget it. Even if I wanted to make such an insignificant gewgaw, I'm liable to chink my tools working on something so delicate and ladylike.
Then shingle it. Pattern weld the item with scap slag. Keep the layers thin. Alternate the overlay.
Okay, smart guy. And where do you propose to find a lump of quality scap slag? Last time I saw one, I could still get rigid down south. Shut your mouth, is that... Where did you...
I had to get my hands dirty.
Well, don't just stand there. Let's do this.
What? You? You're fine with working on something that's not a weapon?
Oh, hell, why not? What? I can grow too.
Oh, watch the spine. Keep your wrist loose.
No, you keep your wrist loose. Yeah, I need more heat here.
Coming up. You gonna temper that steel longer?
You don't need to. I triple quenched it with Draugr oil. See?
How inventive and sanitary. You clever little beaver. Never too late to learn a new trick, is it?
No, it's not. There.
Here it is.
Nope. Don't forget this. Quit your grinning. It's downright unsettling.
It's just nice to see you together. But now the rune on your brand looks different.
Yeah, price of reforging something what broke.
I knew it. You two love each other.
Oh, cut it out, Princess. You're gonna get me all weepy.
I like the new one better. Don't you?
We have work to do.
No. My brother and me got a new project, now that we're on speaking terms. To work it is. Send them all to hell.
You hitting the road or chewing the fat?
What do you want?
With the whetstone and hammer you've retrieved for us, Brock and I can construct the Dvegrathikr, dwarven armor of legend.
We just need three more mythical ingredients before we set to hammering.
Which are?
Dunno. Armor's pure legend, and the details is fuzzier than a wolver's butthole.
You expect us to find parts from a legend?
Oh, Motsognir, the dwarf king, found two of them. Everyone knows that. But when he went looking for the third...
Poof! He vanished. Maybe he'll find some clues at his stronghold in Konungsgard.
And looky here. A Konungsgard entry stone. It's got your name on it. How fucking strange. Their stronghold's northwest of here. Behind the Svartalfheim Realm Tower.
Large stone structure, creepy atmosphere. You'll know it when you see it. The Huldrebrothers are back in action again. Oh, I can't wait to get started.
I'm confused. I always heard that Baldur's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved, something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth.
How so?
Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg.
Like being Baldur's mother.
That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
I'm glad Brock and Sindri were able to work out their differences.
Now they are twice as irritating.
Ah, I think it's nice to see them trust each other again.
Right then, we were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Skadi, Queen of the Hunt, had been lured by Odin into hunting an eagle. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. When she collected her quarry, she found no quarry at all, but her own father, poor Fjordsi, slain by his own daughter. She was overcome with grief and shame. For there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
Aye. There aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.
Boy.
It says, glory to Mjolnir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Konungsgard. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break. I'm feeling creative today. Sometimes the best purchase is the one we don't make.
Whoa. Look, a dragon. But it's chained. Is it a pet?
Do not get any ideas.
Focus up.
The chain is the only thing holding him down.
Odds are there's a bit of magic at play here as well. This is a dwarven stronghold after all.
That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
Focus up! Atreus, to me!
few ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
Yourself.
You'd think this dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to free it.
Seems like the right thing to do.
Look here.
Yes, sir. Wonder who wrote this.
Prepare yourself.
Bigger than Vader.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
'Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Most of Mir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
What?
The Debegrath Eaker. The very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Atreus, to me.
Okay, coming.
Still won't open? Looks like we need three.
Yeah. over here. Why did the Dwarf King want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dveigrath Ikar. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet to...
We're in! Okay. Here we go! Huh. It's kind of run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess? Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Here, boy. Another one.
Starkather. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
Looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. They're getting louder. They sound almost like...
Hellwalkers.
Hey, look at this. Blood truck.
There's a passage behind this throne.
A secret passage?
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Signier.
Huh. Interesting. I may want to write that down.
The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build this? Whatever they are.
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
Yeah.
place looked like in better times.
Conan'sGard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The Dwarf blindly trusted in legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is what it is.
Like you said,
thank you.
Vamir, why do you have Bifrost crystals in your eyes?
A loving gift from the giants. Since I used to do so much traveling between realms, they thought it would be more convenient for me than having a crystal I could lose.
Did it hurt?
No, because I wisely fortified myself with 16 cups of Billow Maiden's Ale. Got so inebriated, I tried convincing the giants to put them in my nipples instead. Almost talked them into it too. Can you imagine? Mimir of the Bifrost cheats. Ah, those were the days. Okay, I'll stop now.
You boys look right beaming.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.